Art can be found anywhere and in sometimes unexpected places. Take, for example, Sky Harbor International Airport. They have their own gallery, and you don't even have to be catching a flight to enjoy it.
Passengers for flight GA642, please go to gate 26.
I've been involved in art programming and as an art educator and art curator for almost 30 years, and I just think it's a great way for people to spark something in them that's beyond the mundane and the shopping experience. I mean, it's very imaginative. Phoenix Airport Museum is one of the oldest and one of the largest airport art programs in the country. There's a common airport joke that airports are always under construction, and so I've heard the joke before that we work at a construction site where planes have to come and go from, and I like to turn that around a little bit and say, you know, we work at a museum where planes happen to come and go from. Our mission is to enhance the airport visitor's experience by creating a memorable environment that showcases Arizona's unique artistic and cultural heritage. The airport is a very public space, and because airports can be kind of homogenous around the country, by putting art and culture in the airport, it really gives kind of a sense of place and a sense of warmth. Traveling can be kind of a stressful, kind of a harried kind of adventure, and being able to pause and kind of see the art can help relax people before they take their flight. And also, because Sky Harbor is in the middle of the city here, it's also a great destination for people that aren't flying, just to come to the airport, maybe on a date night, and see the art and exhibitions throughout the various terminals and, you know, eat at a local restaurant.
Please board here for Terminal 3 and walkway to Terminal 2.
Arts in airports has been kind of an ongoing trend for quite a few years now, and it's just a great way to introduce travelers either coming through Sky Harbor or to the locals of, you know, local art and culture from around our state. When we would call up an artist, we'd want to show their artwork, they were always a little confused, like, why would I want my artwork at the airport? And when we tell them about the amount of people coming through the airport, the millions of passengers and visitors, they realize it's a much better venue than a gallery, and so people from all over the world are coming through the airport. Now artists, of course, are much more wanting to have their artwork shown at the airport. You know, a lot of people have a preconceived idea about a museum being one space, one building, one gallery, but ours is kind of immersive, it's everywhere. I like to say the artwork in the museum is inside, outside, above, and below. If airport visitors want to take the SkyTrain, there's artwork at each platform, which are more architecturally integrated. So these are artist-designed terrazzo floors, designed by artists that are typically doing work in a studio, but then they've scaled their vision to a large platform, 200 feet long. And we have suspended dichroic glass that creates these great reflections on the wall and floor. As part of the museum, we have an aviation history collection. And so we have archives that go back to the beginnings of Sky Harbor on through today. And we have objects such as flight attendant uniforms from the 1940s to the 1980s. You know, we also have very ancient indigenous culture as well, and we have some of that on display, whether it's basketry or pottery from the Pueblo Grande Museum or items from the Grand Canyon. At Terminal 3, we have an outdoor sculpture garden now, which is just a wonderful kind of botanical garden with some great artworks in there. So art is everywhere around Sky Harbor. When people are traveling, I think they have their blinders on, and so they don't always take the time to see the art. But if you've got time, you can go from terminal to terminal and just take in as much as you can and spend as much time as you'd like.
Thank you for joining us on Art in the 48, where we help explore what makes a community beautiful through art. See you next time.